Welcome back to our Getting Started tutorial series. In our previous video, we covered what events in FMOD Studio are and how to use them to play sounds. In this video, we'll be going over what an instrument is in FMOD Studio, as well as how to set up an instrument to play sounds with. To get started, let's go over what an instrument in FMOD Studio is. When we created our ambience event in our last video, we dragged the sound file from the assets tab directly onto the action sheet. FMOD Studio automatically set up the required components to play this sound. These components are called instruments. An instrument is the core component required to play sounds within FMOD sheets. There are regions in which you can assign sounds that are triggered when the playback position passes over them. There's multiple types of instruments, each with their own functionality. In some ways, they are similar to audio clips in your DAW. You can resize the regions, reposition audio, and move sounds between tracks. The key difference between an audio clip in your DAW and instruments in FMOD Studio, however, is FMOD's ability to change between synchronous and asynchronous playback. Synchronous playback means that the sound file within the instrument plays from wherever the playback position is. This means you can select the start position of an audio file by using the playback position in the sheet. Asynchronous playback means that the playback position does not affect where in the sound file you start from. An instrument triggers the sound file when the playback position overlaps it and stops when the audio file has finished playing. This playback system lets FMOD Studio handle complex audio systems. However, for this video, let's focus on the two simplest instrument types, single instruments and multi-instruments. A single instrument is, as the name suggests, an instrument that lets you play a single sound file. You assign a sound to a single instrument, then when the playback position overlaps the instrument region, it will play that sound. A multi-instrument lets you assign multiple sound files to an individual instrument. When the playback position overlaps with a multi-instrument region, the instrument will select one of the assigned sounds based on how you set up the instrument. One of the most common uses for this is to randomly select a sound within a group of sounds for variation. Let's move on to creating an instrument in FMOD Studio. In this case, we have a single birdsong sound. And a series of individual birdsong elements. To see how we create instruments, first create a new event and call this one Single Bird. We can then add a timeline sheet by left or right clicking in the sheets area and selecting Add Timeline Sheet. Lastly, we can add an audio track by right clicking on the master track and selecting Add Audio Track. If you right click in a blank area on the track that you want to add the instrument to, you'll see the list of instrument options appear. In our case, we want a single instrument, so select Add Single Instrument. If you left click the newly created instrument and check the deck, you'll see its properties appear. In the deck, you can see that a single instrument has a sound component. This is where we assign a sound for the instrument to play. While the single instrument is selected, if we switch back to the Assets tab, we can drag any sound file directly into the sound component. Now you can see the waveform of the sound appear in both the instrument region and in the deck. If we now move the playback position over the instrument region and press play, you'll see the instrument is triggered, playing the sound. Speaking of playing sounds, let's go over some of the other properties you can find in the sound component in the deck. In the top left corner of the component, we have the volume knob. This will change the volume of the instrument only. This is separate to the track volume, which is located here. Think of the instrument volume like an audio clip's volume in your DAW. Below the volume, you can see the pitch setting. This lets you adjust the pitch of a sound as it's played in the instrument. Below that, we have Start Offset. This value will make the sound start from later, the higher the percent value is. Lastly, we have the Loop Instrument button, which causes playback of this particular instrument to loop if the sound finishes while the instrument is being triggered. You can specify how many times you want this instrument to loop in the box to the right. Keep in mind that the instrument will only loop on a timeline or parameter sheet if the playback position is over the instrument region. Let's move on to our multiple birdsong sounds. For these, I'd like to be able to play just one instrument, but have it randomly choose one of the different sounds each time it plays or loops. We can use a multi-instrument for this by right-clicking on the timeline and selecting Add Multi-Instrument. The first thing you may notice is that the default color of the multi-instrument is different to the single instrument. Secondly, when you select a multi-instrument, you'll notice that the deck shows a playlist component instead of a sound component. Playlist components have a lot of functionality, but to keep things simple for this video, they let you enter a list of sounds to play instead of just one, like the single instrument. But now, let's head back to the Assets tab, select all our birdsong sounds and drag them into the playlist component. You can now see the playlist component shows all the sounds we added, with the percent value on the right of each sound. This value is the odds of that sound being played, which is called the play percentage. We'll show you this feature in detail in a later video. The other major difference between a single instrument and a multi-instrument is the multi-instrument's playlist component has a drop-down menu here. This menu lets you choose the type of randomization applied to the instrument. This goes a little out of the scope for this video, so let's just leave it with Shuffle. Shuffle selects a random sound from the playlist, but avoids selecting the same sound twice in a row. Now, if we move the playback position to trigger the multi-instrument, each time we press play, you can hear we get a different sound. Using both the single and multi-instruments, you can easily create advanced audio for games. In our next video, we'll be expanding on this by exploring the logic tracks in further detail. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell to keep up to date on all our new videos.